Well, the worst time for me in my ECW career was probably when I injured my neck. We were in a four-way match in Buffalo, New York. It was May 17th, 1997. Terry Funk, Sandman, Raven, and myself. It was a four-way match for the World Heavyweight title. And this was when the BWO was really going strong, and I was on my way to challenging Terry Funk for the world title sometime in June. And during the match, Raven got eliminated first, Sandman got eliminated by me. Right after I pinned the Sandman, Terry Funk lifted the guardrail up in the air. It was supposed to hit me in the back. The top part, which actually had more metal on it at the top, the round part, clipped me in the back of the neck. And I was paralyzed in the ring for like over an hour, and I was scared to death. I thought I was never going to be able to walk again. I thought I was never going to be able to live my life again, and I was very, very frightened. And it turned out to be a really severe stinger, and I had a neck injury. I didn't try to wrestle, but at that point in my career in ECW, Paul Heyman and I were kind of not seeing eye to eye on some things, and me being young and immature and listening to too many people ended up making a series of very rash, bad decisions in my wrestling career. Ended up leaving for WCW in July with almost no notice to ECW, which I regret to this day. And basically burned my bridge with ECW at the time, and regret doing it. Ended up working with the neck injury in WCW, kept getting worse, kept getting stingers, losing feeling in my arms and legs. Finally, December of 97, when me and Raven actually were very heated against each other, pretty much hated each other. I mean, I was brought in by Raven in WCW, reprised my role as Raven's lackey. I thought it was going to be a good opportunity to, you know, get into WCW and do some good things. Raven basically had an argument with me after the Clash of Champions, the last one in Nashville, Tennessee, where he beat me in like 4 minutes and came back and had a little bit of an argument with him where I said, you know, how am I ever going to be able to work you again and have people believe they can get behind me and I can beat you? And he said, well, Stevie, you got to understand, you were only brought in to be my job boy bitch. You were only brought in to be my fucking lackey, you know, and that's the only reason you got in. And if you don't shut your fucking mouth, I'm going to get you fired. Because he knew Diamond Dallas Page, who was best friends with Eric Bischoff, and what did I know? I was just a kid. I didn't, you know if he was lying or trying to scare me. I thought he was my friend, and he was just telling me the truth. So, left WCW in December, went back to ECW, had a ton of heat with the boys, which is totally understandable. I deserved everything I got in ECW because I let the company down. I walked out on them, and I shouldn't have done it. But ended up getting a stinger again in a match with Chris Chetty and decided that I needed neck surgery. So, December 22nd, 3 days before Christmas, I got my neck surgery, was out of wrestling for 5 months, and since then, you know, tried to really, you know, mend broken fences, you know, undo the mistakes I made in the past, and that's something being here in WWE with Tommy, with Bubba, with D-Von, with Spike, with Raven, who's one of my best friends today, something that I just feel like, you know, has come full circle. I just wanted to take time on this DVD and this video to let these guys know that, you know, I'm really, just really sorry about what I did, and it was a mistake, and, you know, I apologize to Paul Heyman, who gave me the ability to become a wrestling superstar and make a name for myself and come here to WWE and do everything, and just, you know, I'm sorry about what I did, and I regret it every day. Since then, I didn't, you know, and I've learned a lot, and I've grown as a person, and I just, stuff like that will never ever happen again.